Now suppose Bob wants to access the printer HP1. That is, Bob wants to send a print job to the printer HP1. His local host sends a ticket granting service request to the KDC. The request contains the ticket granting ticket and an authenticator, which is the current timestamp encrypted using Bob's per day session key SB. When the KDC gets the request, it can decrypt the TGT and it knows that it is a valid TGT because only the KDC has the key to properly encrypt the ID of Bob contained in the TGT. It then uses the key SB contained in the TGT to verify the authenticator by decrypting it and checking the timestamp is current. This proves that the sender is Bob because only Bob has the key SB that can encrypt the current timestamp properly. The KDC then generates a ticket for Bob to communicate with the printer. This ticket contains a session key, KBP, and Bob's ID, and is encrypted using the printer's master key. Note that a network device, such as a printer, has a long and random master key that is configured in, and is typically hard to guess or crack. Therefore, the tickets for these devices are encrypted using their master keys. The KDC sends the ticket granting service response to Bob's local host. It contains the session key KBP, the ID of Bob, and the ticket to the printer, and it is encrypted using Bob's per day key SB. Therefore, only Bob's local workstation can decrypt this and verify that it is from the KDC, because only the KDC can decrypt the ID of Bob correctly with the key SB, because the key SB is embedded in TGT and only the KDC can decrypt the TGT. Then Bob's local host can authenticate itself to the printer. It can send a message to the printer containing the ticket. The authentication request contains the ticket and an authenticator. The authenticator is the ciphertext of the current timestamp encrypted using the share key between Bob's local host and the printer. When the printer gets the ticket, it can decrypt the ticket using his master key shared with the KDC, because the ticket was created by the KDC and it was encrypted using the share key between the printer and the KDC. That is, the printer can verify that the KBP was created by the KDC to communicate with Bob's local host. The print server can then use KBP to verify the authenticator by decrypting the ciphertext and verifying that the result matches with the current timestamp. It then sends a response to authenticate itself by, say, adding 1 to the current timestamp and encrypt it using the share key between Bob's localhost and the printer. And after these authentication steps, then Bob's localhost can send the print job to the printer.